Hi students, welcome back to our chemistry classes. In the previous class, we have learned properties of matter. And also we have learned or we have concluded that matter is made up of particles. In our today's class, we are going to learn different states of matter. We know even 4th standard or 5th standard students also know there are mainly there are three states of matter, solid, liquid and gases. I am not confirming that there are only three states of matter. It is discovered that according to the modern science, it is said that there are near about 12 states of matter are there. So in our NCERT book, it has been there only three states of matter. That's why we are going to learn about that three states of matter only. They are solid, liquid and gas. So it is very very familiar for everyone, the three states of matter: solid, liquid and gas. So first let us learn the properties of the matter that is present in solid state, or we can learn the characteristics of solids. Here the point wise the characteristics have been given, and before going to that point, first you can notice the arrangement of particles in the solid. So here we can see that in solid all the particles are arranged closely or tightly. So why is that this? Because this is the reason for the most of the properties of solids. So let us go to the properties. First one, it is given that solids are rigid and incompressible. Solids are rigid and incompressible. What is meant by rigidity? Rigidity means by applying the force, we can't change the shape of that matter. For example, many solid materials are here, a chalk piece. By applying the force, we are unable to change its shape. Or there will be dust, tables, stones. By applying the force, we won't be able to change the shape of the solids. And next one is incompressible. By applying the force, we cannot reduce the volume of matter, volume of solid. By applying the force, we won't be able to reduce the volume. For example, if there is a chalk piece, if we apply the force, will it be possible to compress it? No, we won't be able to compress it. The reason is that solids are incompressible. So when we are saying this one, you may get the doubt. If there is a sponge, when we apply the force, the sponge will change its shape. How does it? The reason is that actually the sponge, it contains large number of minute pores, minute holes will be there. In all the holes, in all these holes, air will be trapped. Air is present. So when we are applying the force, what happens? Only the air from that pores, it goes out, and remaining solid, it gets calm, it gets closer. Next is property is definite shape and volume. All the solids, they have definite shape. All the solids, if you are seeing a dust, table, test book, or whatever the thing, there will be a definite shape and there must be definite volume. We can measure the volume of solids, so there will be definite volume. Next one is solids of high density. Density of the solids, it will be high. Usually, density of the solids will be high. The reason is that if solids, particles are tightly packed, as the particles are tightly packed, its density will be more. You may have doubt regarding density. What is density? Density is the mass per unit volume, mass divided by volume. So remember, it may ask, what is density? Density is mass by volume, or mass per unit volume is known as density. So next point, diffusion is very slow. Diffusion is very slow. Hope you are remembering what is diffusion. We have learned in the previous class. What is diffusion? Diffusion is the intermixing of particles of different manner by their own. Without applying a force, without mixing artificial themselves, they will mix up. That is known as diffusion. So if we kept it two solids, will there be any chance of diffusing it? That means mixing up of that? No. The reason is that two solids, if we kept, their molecules are tightly packed and they cannot move randomly. That is the reason. Next one, strong intermolecular forces. As the molecules are packed tightly, as the molecules are packed tightly, the attractive force will be more. Attractive force will be more. As the distance increases, attractive force decreases. So as the distance decreases, attractive force increases. Here they are arranged with minimum distance. So attractive force will be maximum. And next one, high melting point. It will be difficult to change it into other states. That means their melting point will be high. Melting point will be high. The reason is that molecules are tightly packed and there will be high intermolecular forces. As the high intermolecular forces are there, it is present, we have to supply large amount of energy to break the bond. Then only it can be converted into liquids. So, hope you have understood the characteristics of solids. Next one, let's go to liquids. Our special state is liquids. So, let us see the arrangement of molecules. Here the molecules when compared to solid. Here, in the liquids, the particles are loosely packed. We can compare the arrangement. Here there will be dark skin. Liquids have no fixed shape. So, liquids won't have any definite shape. It takes the shape of the container. We know if you have taken water in a glass tumbler, it takes the shape of that tumbler. If you have taken water in a bottle, it takes the shape of that bottle. And if you have taken water in a beaker, it takes the shape of the beaker. And next one, it has definite volume. Note it, it does not have definite shape, but it has definite volume. So if you have taken water in a beaker or a vessel or anywhere, we can measure its quantity. There will be a fixed quantity, for example 500 ml or 1 liter or 250 ml. Like that, there will be a definite volume. Next one, liquids have lower density than solids. Density of the liquid is less than that of solids. The reason we know, because the particles are loosely packed. As the particles are loosely packed, their density will be less. Next one, intermolecular force is weaker than those in solids. Intermolecular force, that too, it will be less in the case of liquids. What is the reason for that? That is the same one. What is the arrangement? Arrangement of particles in the liquid is loosely. As they are packed loosely, their attraction also it will be less. I have told you that if the particles are packed tightly, the molecular forces it will be more. As the particles are loosely packed, intermolecular force it will be less. So next one, liquids are slightly more compressible than solids. So as the particles are loosely packed, just little slightly it can be compressed. So next one, diffuse easily than solids. Why they can diffuse easily? The reason is clear. Their particles can move freely. As the particles can move freely, chance of mixing, or there will be chance of mixing it with particles of other matter. So diffusion also it will be fast in the case of solids. Next one, it can flow from higher pressure to, so it can flow from higher level to lower level. So we know all the liquids they can flow, so we can call them as fluids, or they coming under the category of fluids. Fluids means substances which can flow. So here liquid is coming under the category of fluids. So all the points we have learned. Here one more point is, this point is needed some more explanation. So here I have told you that liquids are lower density. That is not applicable in the case of water and ice. We know ice is in solid state and water is in liquid state. But if we drop a ice cube in water, what happens to it? Whether it sinks or it floats. Obviously, it floats on water. It floats on water. So, if it floats on water, what does it mean? Yeah. If it floats on water, the meaning is that density of ice is less than water. So, in this case, ice has less density and water has more density. So, that is the reason. So, don't be confused here. Except that, in the remaining cases, liquids have less density, but solids have more density. Okay, now let's come to gases. In gases, the sticker oxygen arrangement. They are randomly arranged, very loosely arranged. The particles can move anywhere, randomly they can move. So let's go to their properties. No definite shape or volume. It does not have any definite shape, it does not have any volume. So there will be air in the classroom. Is it possible to measure? Or then is it possible to give it a shape? No, the same amount of air, if you have taken and put it in the bottle, it will take the shape of that bottle. So we can say that it does not have any shape or volume. Next one, they are easily compressible. Compressible means by applying the pressure we can reduce its volume. See that as they are loosely packed, by applying the force we can make these particles closer. So we can say that they are easily compressible. Next one is very low density. Densities will be least in this case. So density will be more in the case of solid. Next, liquid. And when come to the gases, density will be least. The reason we know, particles are arranged in this. Next one, diffuse into each other. They can diffuse very easily. Because there will be random movements. As there is random movement, they can move freely anywhere. So there will be chance of mixing up with the particles of other matter. That is known as diffusion. Next one, it can flow from high pressure to low pressure. Gas can move from high pressure to low pressure. So if the particles can move from one place to another, or the substances which shows the fluidity, or which can flow from one place to another, they are known as fluids. So this gas also coming under the category of fluids. So liquids and gases collectively we can call it as fluids. So let us summarize some points. First, there will be chance of asking the question, tabulate the properties of solids, liquids and gases. And also you can ask the question, why does ice float on water? And again, what is mean by density? Density is mass by volume, or mass per unit area is known as density. Or it can ask again the question, why gases have more diffusion rates? Or again, each and every point there it can ask the question, why solids have more density? Why solids have more intermolecular forces. So such a way you can make from this each point you can make many questions. So hope you have understood this topic. Now we can go to another topic, that is interconversion of states of matter. If it is solid, can we change it into liquids? Or if it is a liquid, can we change it into gas? If it is there, let us see how these things.